the Happy Families Podcast. It's the podcast for the time-poor parent who just wants answers now.
We've got to let go of our own agendas, and dinosaurs are the thing that light her up at the moment.
And now here's the stars of our show, my mum and dad.
If you are in Queensland or any number of other Australian states right now, it's an exciting day. School holidays, Queensland, New South Wales, Victoria, ACT.
Woohoo! We made it through out the term.
If the kids are at public schools, this is it. School's over for a couple of weeks. And doesn't that feel good?
It feels so good.
In 2 weeks' time, we're going to be saying,
there are no more lunchboxes for 2 whole weeks.
In 2 weeks' time, we're going to be like, I wish that school holidays didn't go this long. I can't wait to tell you about our school holidays.
I don't have to iron uniforms or even know where they are for 2 whole weeks.
And we're going to have some fun with the kids.
Yes, I can't wait.
We are Justin and Kylie Coulson. We're the parents of 6 kids. I'm the author of a bunch of books about raising happy families and the founder of happyfamilies.com.au. And this is the Happy Families Podcast. Every Friday, we talk about I'll Do Better Tomorrow. It's a whole bunch of ideas that we've picked up as we've considered what's gone on over the last week in our family and figure out ways that we can be more intentional next week, either by having got stuff right or having gotten stuff wrong. Bad English.
Very bad.
Having got stuff right. Before we start, though, as always on an I'll Do Better Tomorrow Friday,
we do our little wins Wednesday winner.
Yeah, so every Wednesday on Facebook, we ask you about your little wins with your little ones, and we pick a winner who picks up a 12-pack of our A5 posters. All the Justinisms, all the stuff that I say to help make your family happier. Kylie, I haven't got my glasses on. They're over on the other table. So can you please tell us who won and why they won with their little wins and their little ones?
Well, let's just say her name's Stephanie, because I'm not even going to try and say that last name and I don't want to get it wrong. But she said, Mr. Six was really excited this morning to go and try out a homeschool chess club for the first time. But he was also feeling really nervous about it, and I could see that he was pretty close to a big emotional outburst. I was frantically trying to think what to do so he wouldn't melt down and would be able to enjoy the experience. And then I remembered last week's Lighten the Load.
So I'll just jump in here really quickly. Lighten the Load is our weekly newsletter that all Happy Families members receive that gives people great ideas on how to make their family happier. And it sounds like it did that for Stephanie. So what happened when she remembered last week's Lighten the Load newsletter?
After 5 things he could see, he was visibly calmer. And after things he could feel, he was smiling again. The instructor started at that point and my son had a great time. There were a couple of little emotional overflows at other points, but I was really proud of how well he was able to calm himself down with some assistance from me. Plenty of other times this would have ended with us needing to leave early because it was just too overwhelming in a new place with lots of new people. Such a win for him and me. Thanks for that little email tip reminder.
So for those who have missed the whole 5 things he could see, 4 things he could feel. When your kids are starting to get a little bit emotional, before it gets all too much, we get them to focus on their senses, to really ground themselves, to be present right here, right now with 5 things they can see, 4 things that they can feel, 3 things that they can hear, 2 things that they can smell, and 1 thing that they can taste.
Emily tried to take you through that the other night, didn't she, in bed?
Our 7-year-old came and jumped into bed and said, Daddy, 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 what's 5 things you can smell? And I knew straight away what she was doing. I'm like, no, 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 you mean 5 things that I can see? Oh, yeah.
So what's 4 things you can smell? No, not smell.
What can I feel? What's 3 things you can smell? No, we've got to do here next. And what about 2 things? Yeah, we can do 2 things we can smell. That was a lot of fun. So congratulations, Stephanie. Thanks for jumping in and chiming in with Little Wins Wednesday, your little wins with your little ones. We're going to take a break from that over the holidays, but I'm sure that we'll resurrect it again in term 3 so that we can celebrate the little wins that you have with your little ones. Now, Kylie, who's going to go first, you or me, when it comes to I'll Do Better Tomorrow and a quick analysis of either what worked or what didn't and how we can be more intentional tomorrow with our parent-child relationships?
Well, I had a really cool win this week.
So did I, but you go first. Ladies before gentlemen.
A few weeks ago, I shared that Miss Emily has been taking me through a completely different nighttime routine. Instead of me talking about all of these cutesy little stories that I have loved reading to my children for the last nearly 20 years, I have now turned to information books, and she has pulled out every stop. I'm reading about dinosaurs and dragons and ants and bees and habitats and environments, and she has just loved it.
She's fallen in love with dragons, like crazy about dragons. And it reminded me of this old song that my parents raised me on from Anne Murray. I don't know if you remember this one. I hope you do.
Hey, Daddy, there's a dragon in the driveway.
Oh, yeah.
Mama, there's a grizzly on the lawn.
Did you grow up with any of this?
I did not. Really? You introduced you all of these to me when we had kids.
So there's a hippo in the bathtub.
We get some and real volume when this one goes on in the car.
So we grew up with this, and my parents used to play it all the time. And every time Emily starts talking about the dragons, I just think of Hey Daddy by Anne Murray, this dragon in the driveway, this hippo in the bathtub. Anyway, so you've been obviously spending some time with our baby girl around this.
I have. And one of the things that I love doing is a bedroom makeover. Recently, Emily has made it very, very clear that the pink doona cover that she has and the flamingos that are all over her walls, which she painted, I might add, are no longer what she would like to be looking at every day.
She just wants to see
dinosaurs.
That reminds me, I love that classic ad. Do you remember the ad for the natural confectionery? The kids used to scream this at the top of their lungs every time we'd bring the lollies out and they'd pull the dinosaur out, and then there'd be...
Don't chop the dinosaur, Daddy.
Don't chop the dinosaur, Daddy.
Don't chop the dinosaur, Daddy.
So anyway, she wants dinosaurs. And I rang you and I actually said, Emily's been asking for a dinosaur room. I think I'm going to do it. What did you say?
I said, you know what? It's really hard for me to admit this, but I said, really? Because she's my little girl and I'm so used to all of our girls having these girly rooms, and now we're going to have this dinosaur room? Now, I know that I know theoretically at every level that's fine, it's wonderful, but she's hanging out with all these boys at school and she's into dragons and dinosaurs and it's so unfamiliar to me.
Well, we've had six girls. I've never had to do a dinosaur room ever.
And it kind of did my head in. I really love it, but at the same time I'm like, wow, what is going on here?
Well, I needed some retail therapy
now,
that day.
Now that I've got my head around it, go for your life.
I needed some retail therapy. It's been a hard week. We're really missing Benson. And so I just thought, you know what? I'm just going to go and do it. So I went out. And I started at IKEA because they've got some gorgeous plush dinosaurs. And I thought that's a great place to start. So I ended up getting these dinosaurs and I got fake trees and we had some cut logs in the backyard and I pulled them in with some rocks and she is in heaven.
This room looks like it's a dinosaur fantasy. It's so good. And this is your incredible ability.
I did have to steal our fake plants because...
Yeah. We no longer have fake plants anywhere in the house. They're all just crowding the jungle that has become Emily's room. So your take-home message around this I'll do better tomorrow concept is?
We've got to let go of our own agendas. I loved the flamingo room. It was really hard for me to take it all down. But the reality is it's not her thing.
Mm.
And dinosaurs are the thing that light her up at the moment. And she just, from the moment we started putting it all together, I couldn't get her out of there. She just was engrossed and engaged, and there's nothing that I love more than seeing my children engaged in their play.
We'll pop a photo of the bedroom up so that everyone can see it on Facebook and find out what you've done to be creative in your kids' bedrooms. Up next, we'll find out about my I'll Do Better Tomorrow and talk a bit more about the upcoming school holidays.
It's the Happy Families Podcast.
Imagine a home where discipline got results without anyone having to feel bad or in trouble. The Do's and Don'ts of Discipline is a webinar to help parents set limits with love, compassion and humanity. Find it now at happyfamilies.com.au/shop.
It's the Happy Families Podcast, the podcast for the time poor parent who just wants answers now. And today we've been sharing our insights of our week and the things that we've learned.
Or made mistakes around.
Yeah.
Or done well.
Well, you teased us. You said you did well this week, so.
I did. In fact, a couple of things have gone well. First up, last Saturday we did Better Together. This was a webinar workshop with 50 couples talking about how to strengthen their relationships. And the feedback was overwhelmingly, amazingly positive. People were saying, this is just what our relationship needed. We were not doing so well and we've had the best weekend, the best connection, the best conversations we've had in years. it just it feels so good to make a difference in people's lives, families, relationships, and that was a real highlight. And it helped us to be a lot more intentional about our relationship as well, which was great. But the thing that really did it for me this week was just one afternoon after school, I'd been working all kinds of hours, doing webinars at night, working all day, kind of just doing the stuff that so many parents do where you're busy working and you don't get time with the kids. And I just thought, one afternoon, blow it. I've done enough of this. I need to see my kids. And so I walked out the door and she said, I'm done at about 3:30, 4 o'clock one afternoon, took them to the park, kicked a ball, threw a frisbee, pushed them on the swings, just the three little ones. It's so simple. And the word that comes to mind is it was just heaven.
I think you had a milkshake. The kids dobbed you in. Did you have a milkshake and you didn't bring me one home?
I don't think that I had one. I think I bought one for everyone else though. You know what I'm like? I'm too cheap to buy one for myself.
Or me, clearly.
I hate spending $8 on a drink. It's ridiculous. And there were three kids with me. You know how many milkshakes I could have made at home with $24? That's milkshakes for a month. Unbelievable. I'll do better tomorrow. I don't know. Is that a win? Am I getting it right if I buy the kids milkshakes? Or is that a bad budgetary decision that just crosses out all the good that I did by spending time with the kids?
I think getting frustrated that you spent the money is where you went wrong.
All right. I should just gladly hand it over. Here, have $8 for 500 milliliters of milk. Gosh.
But it tastes so good.
Hey, it's school holidays just around the corner for most states starting this afternoon. That means that you and I, Kylie, are going to, well, we're going to keep the podcast going with 3-minute reminders each morning. We're going to keep it really short. A couple of bonus episodes in the holidays with some interviews and other good stuff. But we're really going to just do our best to help everyone to have a happier family with 3-minute snippets. We could call it 3-minute therapy. Just to help people have a happier family. So that's going to kick off.
Can you talk for less than 3 minutes?
That's going to kick off from Monday. I can't believe you said that. Gosh. Do you want to do the outro stuff then since I've talked so much?
No.
Come on.
The Happy Families Podcast is produced by Justin Roulon.
From?
Bridge Media.
Yeah. Our executive producer.
Our executive producer is...
Come on, you talk to me all the time.
Craig. Is Craig Bruce.
Craig, are you ever going to forgive Kylie for that? That
is just... You are so unfair to me.
Yeah, and what happens next?
You are so unfair.
Come on.
What am I supposed to say now?
If you really love the podcast.
If you really love the podcast, you can contact us on... You can contact us at...
Give everyone your phone number.
You can contact us at podcasts.com.au.
No one's going to get us if they do that. There's podcasts at happyfamilies.com.au. But that was supposed to be the bit where you ask people to leave us a rating and review because they love us so much, or they love you so much.
They won't love me this much anymore.
Just do that bit. I think we should drag this on all the way to the very end.
Craig, save me.
If you enjoy the podcast, you can leave us a rating and review at Apple Podcasts. Those ratings and reviews help other people to find out about the podcast and make their families happier. And if you'd like any more information about making your family feel great, you can find it at
happyfamilies.com.au.
Oh, we need a holiday.